Good morning, students. Hope all of you are doing well. Today I'm going to discuss about the operations of integers. Okay, so at previous video I discussed about integers and how to solve these problems, how to count the steps to the right of zero, left of zero, or ascending order or descending order, and absolute value. Okay, so those things I discussed in my previous video. Also discussed the exercise 4.1, all question answer. Okay, so today I am going to discuss about operation on integers. Okay, so what so addition and subtraction, two operation already we learned. So here actually how to operate the integers in addition. So addition, here we will discuss the directions and rules to be followed while adding positive as well as negative numbers. Okay, so suppose the direction one is that when a positive integer is added to a number. So if a positive integer, see this example, +3 is a positive integer, is added to a number +2. So move towards the right of the number line. So you know that in number line, the right of zero is positive side and left of zero is negative side. So in find the value of +3 +2. So the first positive integer is +3. Then we are adding +2 integer, that means again we are adding the positive integer +2. So for this we have to draw the number line. Okay, then you start at +3, because +3 +2, so at first you go to +2, so start at +3, then move two step, because you see here that +2 means we are adding +2 positive integer with +3 positive integer. Okay, so start at +3, then move two steps, because +2 is here, so we will take two steps to the right as +2 is a positive integer. Okay, then you see the number line, so you start from here, so +3, we start at +3, then we will take two steps, one step and then second step. So first step and second step. So after getting is two step, we will reach +5. So reach +5, hence we have +3 +2 equals to +5. So if we will add +3 positive integer with +2 positive integer, then we will get +3 +2 is equal to +5. See here, after taking a two steps, we will reach +5 position. Okay, in number line. So second question also, you see that because here already I told you, here in this part of this chapter we will discuss not only the positive integer as well as the negative integer. Okay, so you see the second question, find the value of -6 +3. So you see here -6 is a negative integer, positive integer. Yes, it is a negative integer. Okay, it is not a positive integer. See the sign, the negative sign, so that's why it is a negative integer. So +3. So you see, at first, what is the first step of our to solve this problem? At first we have to draw the number lines, because without number line you don't do this, maybe it will make mistake. So you try to draw a number line. So here actually that number line is already have drawn. So you see that start at -6. So where is this -6? -6 is here. Then you see that +3. So move three steps to the right, because +3, so we will take three steps. It is a plus sign, that's why we will take the three step right side of -6. So -6 right side means this side. So we will take +3 positive step. So you see here one step, then -5, then one again another step, second step, so we will reach -4, and last step, so means third step, we will reach -3. So you see here start at -6, then move three steps to the right as +3 is a positive integer. Because +3 is a positive integer, so we will take three steps to the right of -6. So -6 right side means this side. So after taking a +3 positive steps, then we will reach at minus 3. So reach minus 3, thus minus 6 plus plus 3 is equal to minus 3. So you see here it's very easy. If you draw the number line and then you start to do solve this problem, then it will be easy to solve it, okay? And second, this is a first direction to how to solve this type of problem. The second direction is that when a negative integer is added to a number. So up to this, you see there that positive integer is added with a positive integer, here a positive integer with added with a negative integer. But here we are seeing the second direction is that when a negative integer is added to a number. So move towards the left of the number line. So you know that the right side of 0 is positive and the left side of 0 is negative. So when we will go in left side, that means we will going to the negative side, okay? So see here that example 6. So evaluate plus 6 plus minus 2. So you see here for this also we have to draw the number line at first. So see here number line at first you have to draw, then you start at plus 6, because plus 6 plus minus 2. So where is the plus 6? Plus 6 is here. So after taking a minus 2, so means this is a negative integer. So we have to take two steps, because 2 is here, so we have to take the two steps to the left of plus 6. So plus 6, two steps left means so one step, second step, first step, second step. After taking a first step, we will reach plus 5. Then again you take a second step for another step, so you will reach plus 4. So start at plus 6, then move two steps to the left, as minus 2 is a negative integer. It is a negative integer, so that's why we will go left side of minus plus 6. So reach plus 4, see here, reach plus 4, thus plus 6 plus minus 2 is equal to plus 4. Okay, so hope all of students, you will understand how to solve this type of problems. It will be very much easy. At first, the first step is you have to draw the number line. Then you see that what is your first number. If it's a negative, so negative integer, so means minus 3. So you had find that where is the minus 3. Then after that, you see notice that how many. It is a positive sign or negative sign, what is inside of the first bracket. So if it will be negative, then we will have to go to that left side, and if it will be positive, then you will have to go to the right side of that number. Then you see what is the number is in within first bracket. So if it's 1, so you have to take the one step. If it will be 2, then you have to take the two steps. 3, how many number will be there, that much steps you have to take. So you see here, start at minus 3. So you see it's minus 3 is here. Then move one step, because the number that is in first bracket is 1. So we have to take the one step. So move one step to the left, as minus 1 is a negative integer. See minus 1, so it is a negative integer. So we have to go to the left side of minus 3. So minus 3 is here. Minus 3 left side means this side. So after taking a one step, we will reach minus 4. So after reaching minus 4, so means this is the result. So thus minus 3 plus minus 1 equals to minus 4. Okay. So what is the rule? To add two positive integers, find the sum of their absolute values and place a positive sign before it. So after taking a sum, so see here, because this is a plus sign, so it's all those are sum. So we have to, don't forget to write the sign. Means it will be positive or negative, the sign is very much important. Don't forget this sign. So to add two positive integers, find the sum of their absolute values and place a positive sign before it. You have to write the what sign. If see here, in here, that's all the sum are positive, so that's why it is a positive sign. We are making a positive sign, but here it will come negative, so we have to write the negative sign. So that things you have to check, okay? So example 8, find the value of plus 16 plus plus 5. So sum of absolute values, see here, you take that mode. So within parallel lines, two parallel lines, you have to write the numbers. So plus 16. So what is the absolute value of is it? 16. And here also 5. So 16 plus 5 means 21. So place positive sign before the sum. So see here. Here also sign is positive. Here also sign is positive. So then that what sign will come here? Positive. Okay. So to add second rule. So this is the first rule. Example is here is given here. See that that add two positive integers. See here this plus 16 and plus 5 are two positive integers. Find the sum of their absolute values. So absolute values, how to find out? We know that we will write the number within two parallel lines. Then you just ignore the sign and only what is the number is in two parallel lines, that number only you have to write. Place a positive sign before it. You see here the positive sign, you have to write before you write that answer. Okay. So exam rule number 2, to add two negative numbers, find the sum of their absolute values and place a negative sign before it. Like as addition, same things we are doing for this two like two positive integer sums, we will same things we will do at negative integers. So see here this number, we have to take the so sum of absolute values. So within two parallel lines, when you write the minus 12, then what number you will get? 12 plus 9. So 12 plus 9 is 21. But in front of these two numbers, the negative sign is here. So you have to write the answer is in negative sign. Rule number 3, to add a positive integer with a negative integer, find the difference of their absolute values and put the sign of the integer with the greater absolute value before it. So see here example. So find the value of plus 22 plus within bracket minus 18. Difference of absolute values is plus 22 and minus 18 is equal to 22 minus 18 is equal to 4. Integer with greater absolute value. So within two parallel lines, you write the number plus 22. So sign before plus 22 is a positive sign. You see here, positive sign. So sum will be plus 22 plus minus 18. So plus 22 minus 18. So means if we subtract 18 from 22, what number we will get? Plus 4. Okay. So like this way, you have to solve this problem. So only few things you remember. Rule 1, rule 2, rule 3. You just remember what is the sign is it. So at first you take the absolute value and then you find out the what is the sign. You just when you write the answer, you put the signs. Okay. So see here that positive here also you see that plus 22. So we are subtracting minus 18 18 from 22. 22 is the large number. So large number sign, what is it? Is a positive integer, that's why it will come positive integer. Okay. So to add a positive integer with a negative integer, find the difference of their absolute values and put the sign of the integer with the greater absolute value before it. See that what is the greater absolute value? This one, that sign will put here. So that's why plus 4, because plus 22, that absolute value is the bigger one. That's why that sign will put in front of the answer. Okay. Hope all of you understood. So next part of this chapter. So see here, example 11. Evaluate plus 13 plus minus 23. So see here, this number is a positive integer, this number is a negative integer. So at first you have to find the absolute value of this number. So for this, you know what is the rule. You put those that number within two parallel lines and then you put the second number minus 23. That also put in two parallel lines. So 23, here you see that minus 23. So it negative integer is the, you see this number, if you remove the sign, then you the 23 is the bigger one than 13. So 23 you write at first, then minus 13, so it will be 10. But you see that we are subtracting minus 23 from 13. So minus 23 is that that number, so integer with greater absolute value. So minus 23, So you see sign before minus 23, what is the negative sign? So that sign will put, because I told you what is that, what integer the greater absolute value, that sign we have to put before the answer. So you see here that my subtraction will be 10, but that what sign will be we will put, which have a greater absolute value. So minus 23 have a greater absolute value is 23, so that's why that sign. So before 23, what is the sign? Is it minus? So we have to put minus sign. So next question is the subtraction. So addition, I hope all of you have understood. So in subtraction, as positive integer are nothing but natural number, let us begin with an ordinary subtraction of two natural numbers. So you see here we are subtracting 5 from 9. So 9 minus 5 equals to, you know, this is a normal subtraction, we will write 4. But expressing this as subtraction of positive integer we have. So if you if in your question is giving the questions like that, plus 9 minus or plus 5, so positive integer plus 9 minus plus 5, positive integer plus 5. So what number we will get? See here that now observe the sum of this this one, we will get here plus 4. So but now observe the sum of plus 5 plus minus 5. So that time you see here you have to draw the number line, then you start at plus 9. What is the plus 9? Plus 9 is the right side of 0. So see here, right side of 0 means this side, so plus 9 is here. Then you will take minus 5 step. Minus 5 means minus signs means the left side of plus 9, because you see that minus sign is here. How many steps you have to take? 5, because 5 is here, so 5 steps you have to take. So 1 step, 2 step, 3 steps, 4 steps, 5 steps. So after getting 5 steps we will reach plus 4. So from direction 2 in addition, plus 9 plus minus 5 is equal to plus 4. Or otherwise you can, if you think like this way, if you take that absolute value, then plus 9 absolute value is what will be 9, and minus 5 absolute will be 5. But you see here here actually that we will not do this type of rule, because if you take that absolute value, then this number and this number will add, that will not match with this number. So we will not go through that rule. So that is to say, instead of subtracting plus 5, if opposite integer has been added to get the same result. The opposite integer in this case is known as the additive inverse. So see here, minus 5 additive inverse rule. So here is the minus 5, it is opposite sign, plus 5, 0, it will be 0, additive inverse is same, plus 6, minus 6, plus 7, minus 7, plus 8, minus 8. So you like this way, the additive integers are that same integers but its opposite sign. If we'll give here positive one, then it will come in negative. If it will come in negative, then it will come in positive. Okay, same. So subtraction is the addition of the additive inverse of an integer. Okay, so example 12 with the subtract plus 9 from plus 7. So additive inverse of plus 9 is minus 9. So thus plus 7 minus of plus 9, so plus 7 plus minus 9, so it what number we will get? Minus 2. Yes, so subtract minus 6 from minus 3. So if I have to find out the additive inverse of minus 6, so which number is subtract, that you find out the additive inverse of that number. Okay, so here's also subtract minus 6. So here you see that subtract plus 9, that's why we will find out the additive inverse of plus 9, not plus 7. Here also subtract minus 6, so that's why we will find out the additive inverse of minus 6 is plus 5, 6. So that's minus 6 minus of minus 6 is equal to minus 6 plus 6, so means it will be 3. So like this way you please solve those problems, and also I'm providing one worksheet, you please do it. In my next video, I will discuss the worksheet question answers. Okay, thank you students. Be safe at your home. Bye.